I knew nothing about cancer. You know, I literally had to find out, okay, what are the effects of cancer? What does it do to you? One of those things. I never had any sources of telling me what to do. I mean, you go into Google and then one page says X and then another page says Y. Conflicting information, and then I lost trust in Google. And then I just spoke to people that has been through the journey. You know, I also spoke to people that had family members that's gone through the journey as well. So they could speak to me about things. And the way they spoke to me was more in a positive way, as opposed to the negative reviews I would find on Google. And then at the same time, speaking to my oncologist, you know, he was also very educational. He wasn't just him telling me things. I could literally ask him questions and he would answer me. It wasn't just, okay, Mr. Madrid, and here's this cancer, okay, bye. We literally would sit for about almost half an hour to an hour. It was like me going to a friend discussing something that they saw in the paper. And that's how I managed to get a lot of information on how to really attack it. I've also had a lot of people reach out to me, a lot of they have this cancer care networking group where it's like a social worker. They really then make sure that you are okay. And I remember once they connected me with this one cancer survivor as well. And she was like, this, I'm like, but you know what? I don't have cancer. That was my belief. I just believe that there is no cancer, so there's nothing for me to worry about. It was more the people on the outside that worried. And that was my biggest challenge, is making everybody feel that I'm gonna be okay. So in terms of researching, not much, but I had people as well telling me, ooh, you must be scared about this, what about that? I'm like, where are your facts? I didn't go as far as to getting all the detail. I always tell people, you know, the more I focus on the detail, the more I'm gonna forget where I want to be. I'm more focused on where I want to be. And I want to live because I love living life. And a lot of people would always say that I'm in love with life. If I could marry life, I would. But I'm not interested in what went wrong. I'm not interested about the detail. I always tell people when they ask what happened when somebody dies, like, why does it matter if the person is dead? You know, asking that question is literally just taking me back to an emotional state where I've lost somebody. And I, you know, right now, I also want to focus on the happiness.